Welcome, 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 you guys. Welcome to the Super Elite Entertainment Show live with Jason Rodriguez. We're about to get started momentarily, so I'm going to kindly ask you to please share this broadcast into your timeline, guys. Let's go. Come on. Upload that link. Share it. Send it to somebody. I see you. I see you there, Giovanni Alvarez, my co-host. Hey, I see you. Wanda Flores, way out there in Florida. I see you. Let's share this live broadcast into your timeline. Upload the link. Send it to somebody. Tonight, it's a little different. It's a one-man show. It's just going to be me, myself, and I. Well, not really just me, myself, and I. I'm also going to have Lola Rodriguez. And Paco is going to be joining me. On the camera is going to be my co-host, Giovanni Alvarez. We're going to be doing a featuring the first episode tonight of Paco, Live with Paco. And that was filmed at Spark City Smoke and Vape Shop in the city of Bridgeport. We're about to get started momentarily, guys. So share this live broadcast into your timeline. Big shout out to my boy, Tony Barr from the city of Bridgeport. I see you right there as well. Huepa lo fuimos. We're going to get started momentarily, guys. Don't go anywhere. Here we go. One. All right, you guys, share this live broadcast into your timeline. Welcome to Super Elite Entertainment. This show is brought to you by Aces Bell Bond, Yasmin Khan, Quick Response 24/7, Easy Payment 203-257-6228. Ramirez Spanish Restaurant, specializing in seafood y churrasco. Spark City Smoke and Vape Shop, located at 815 Lafayette Boulevard in Bridgeport, Connecticut. Evolution Sports Bar and Cafe, located at 1279 North Avenue in Bridgeport. Bridgeport Auto Glass, 1227 Barnum Avenue in Bridgeport, Connecticut. Visit www.bridgeportautoglassshop.com. And finally, Moran Insurance Agencies, protecting your future. Call 203-864-6232 or visit www.moraninsuranceagencies.com. Time. Welcome to Super League Entertainment, guys. You already know I'm your host, Jason Rodriguez, broadcasting from the city of Bridgeport, Connecticut. I hope how you guys doing? I hope you're feeling good. I hope you're having a good day. You already know I open up always with a dance. Every single show, I open up with a dance. Back in the day, I used to be able to break dance. Oh, I don't know what happened to the camera there. Froze. The camera froze because my dancing skills are terrible. What's up, you guys? Welcome, welcome, welcome to the show tonight. Broadcasting from the Super Elite Entertainment Studio right here in downtown Bridgeport. I'm excited, man. I'm excited to be here in the studio. Wow, what's going on with my camera here? Wait a minute. Let's see. Okay, there we go. All right, the camera's functional. All right, and all right, the camera's gonna stop ticking. All right, there we go. Whoo! Oh, wait a minute. What's going on here today? All right, let's go to this camera. How about that? Close up. Now you get to see all my little wrinkles. You get to see all my little pimples. All my little, my little white pelitos and all that good stuff that people get when they reach a certain age. All right, let me turn this down. All right, guys, so how you doing? Hope you're doing well. All right, I just have to say right off the rip, I had a guest that was supposed to join me here tonight in the studio. Unfortunately, things went, I don't want to say sour. Things just went a little bad, not even bad. We just had a miscommunication with the date, a miscommunication with the guest that was supposed to be here tonight, Robert Zarenda from Hall Neighborhood House, an amazing, amazing organization, which is located right here in the city of Bridgeport. He was supposed to be here with me in the studio tonight, and unfortunately, he was not able to make it, and that's okay. That's what happens when you're doing a live show. Sometimes a guest at the last minute will reach out to you and tell you, hey, listen, unfortunately, I have something going on that's preventing me from being able to participate in the show. So it's all right. I'm all right. I'm not upset. And, that's why, I'm not going to make this a biblical thing, but in the Bible, it says be ready in season and out of season. So, I mean, unfortunately, I guess I'm going to show if I'm ready tonight. So I'm winging it. I'm weaking it. But that's all right, because tonight I have Lola, la princesa. The diva, hashtag diva status. Lola is going to be joining me here in the studio. And also I have Paco. Paco's going to be, Paco's not going to be joining me here in the studio itself, but he's going to be joining us tonight because we did an episode with Paco, and it's called Live with Paco, and it was filmed at Spark City Smoke and Vape Shop, which is located right here in Bridgeport, Connecticut, 815 Lafayette Boulevard. So I want to give a big shout out to my good friend Z from Spark City Smoke and Vape, who not only did he allow us to film the first episode there at Spark City, but also he is one of the main, if I should say, the main actors in the episode that's going to be taking place. I'm telling you guys, don't go anywhere. You're going to love it tonight. I guarantee you, you're going to have a blast. So let's see what's going on here. The best of the best, Mr. Jason Rodriguez. God bless you always. Albert Grajales, thank you so much, my brother. I truly appreciate that. Also, I got to give a big shout out to my co-host, Giovanni Alvarez, who's right there always in punto, on point, watching the show. Gio, I see you. And by the way, when we showed the episode of Paco taking place at Spark City Smoke and Vape, the person behind the camera is no other than Giovanni Alvarez, my co-host. So, big shout out to Z and Giovanni Alvarez. Listen, guys, don't go anywhere. You're going to love the skit. You're going to love the episode, man. We're going to have a blast with that tonight. So, let's see. I got a couple of things in my head that I've been thinking about today to talk with you. First of all, I want to welcome each and every one of you that's listening to us on our podcast, whether you're listening on Anchor, Spotify, Apple Podcasts, Radio Republic. Welcome to the show tonight. Big shout out to all of you essential workers as well who have been out there working so extremely hard in the midst of this crazy pandemic. You guys been showing up to work and, doing your thing, holding it down and showing up first, second, third shift and making sure that because of your presence at your job site, we as a community are able to have the essentials that we need. Gio, live with Jason and Gio will be back next Tuesday night. Next Tuesday night, my co-host Giovanni Alvarez will be joining me here in the studio. We're going to be coming ready for another amazing show. Also, I want to mention, for any business owners that are out there, business owners, you guys, the city of Bridgeport, especially if you're in Bridgeport, well, actually, it's only for the Bridgeport businesses. But if you are a business owner in the city of Bridgeport, I'm going to encourage you tonight to make sure that you visit BPT200.com. Go and register your business tonight on that website. Free advertisement. Advertisement is expensive. When you're driving on the highway and you see those big billboards, just to be on that billboard, I think for like a week or two, it's about $5,000. All right. Advertisement is expensive. To be on the Coastal Link or the city bus that you see moving around the city, that stuff is expensive, man. The city of Bridgeport is providing businesses in the city of Bridgeport a free opportunity to be a part of the BPT 200. Register your business. I'm going to be the person most likely to come down to your business and film a 30-second video. A 30-second video, which is going to be featured on the City of Bridgeport website, BPT.com website. I believe the City of Bridgeport website. I'm not correct, 100% sure if it's going to be on the City of Bridgeport website, but it will be on the BPT 200 website. It's going to be on the City of Bridgeport YouTube channel and a whole bunch of other different platforms that the City of Bridgeport has. So if you're a business owner, if you own a hair salon, a pharmacy, a bodega, a gas station, you know, a smoke lounge, whatever the case may be, a restaurant. If you have a restaurant specifically, especially if you're a restaurant owner, make sure you go onto that website, register with www.bpt200.com, and they're gonna be reaching out to you. They're gonna schedule me to come down to your business so that I can film a 30-second video, and that video is gonna go far. It's gonna be exposed to many, many different people, not only in the City of Bridgeport, but statewide. Videos go far today, all right, guys? And it's going to be posted all over the place. So make sure that you take full advantage of the BPT200.com and register as soon as you can. Woo! All right, let's see who's on the check-in right here real quick. Let's see. Wanda. I see you, Wanda. You said you got the right. You got that right. What dance moves? Yeah. Thank you. I appreciate that. Gio, I see you right there. I see my sister watching as well, way out there in Arizona. Oh, actually, my mother's watching, and she's using my sister's cell phone. And, of course, my mother is always on the check-in. SK General is saying, good evening, my brother. Good evening right back to you. Thank you for the support, brother. I truly appreciate that. Gio, thank you always for telling people, you know, welcoming the people into the show when you're not here, because Gio was with me every other week. And like Gio says, welcome everyone to Super Elite Entertainment. Please, please, please share this broadcast into your timeline. Lola, relax. She's over here looking at me with this little sour face. Relax. You're going to get your opportunity soon, all right? Relax. I mean, she's always ready to create problems and to cause trouble. Relax, Lola. I got you, girl. I got you. And, you know, we're going to get this shortly. One more way. Jen Mezzo, thank you. Thank you for tuning in tonight. Again, Tony Bard, thank you for tuning in tonight. And so many other. I see also Madison, Marie, Evelyn, Kyle, and a whole bunch of you are watching. All right. I talk too much. I can sit here all day and keep talking. But let's see what else I had to share with you guys. Listen, guys, just, you know, continue living your life, pursuing your dreams, pushing forward toward the mark that has been set before you. My goal on this show is to always bring you some hope, some inspiration, some encouragement in the midst of whatever storm that you may be going through. We all face storms. We all encounter difficult times. But I just want to encourage you, man, to keep your head up. Keep your head up. And in the midst of whatever you're going through, continue pushing forward. Don't fall by the wayside. Don't give up. That job that you're trying to get is just right there around the corner. It might take maybe 3 or 4 extra steps, but that opportunity will present itself. The thing is that you have to be ready in season and out of season, because you never know when that opportunity is going to come your way. All right, so don't give up. Continue conquering. Continue persevering. Continue believing in your dreams. Continue pressing forward toward the mark that has been set before you. And I guarantee you that in due time, at the right time, that opportunity is going to reap a harvest of blessing in your life. All right. I feel like I'm preaching. I feel like I'm ready to pass the offering bucket and collect an offering. Yeah, because we need some donations over here. No, I'm just kidding. We don't need no donations. We're doing okay over here. Thank be to God that each and every week and each and every month, God supplies our needs according to his riches and glory and gives us what we need here in our studio, which is located right here in downtown Bridgeport, the substance we need to continue surviving. We're creeping up to almost 3 years. I can't even believe it. We've been here almost 3 years right here in Bridgeport, man. And, you know, I thank God for each and every day, each and every week, each and every month and year that we are here alive and able to do what we do. Minerva Ramos, I see you also with the hand. You know, I see you also waving your hand, Minerva. Thank you for tuning in tonight. Pero, All right, we're going to take a quick break, guys. We're going to take a quick break, and then I don't know how this is going to play out because Lola's right here looking at me with this little nasty, feisty face, ready to just set it off, ready to create chaos, to cause trouble. But we're going to take a quick break, guys. Don't go anywhere. All right? Lo fuimo? Yeah, I think lo fuimo. Here we go. Enjoy. Don't go anywhere.
Are you in good hands? In the Moran Insurance Agency, we are here to protect your future.
Guys, join me. Let me show you around. It's all about protecting what's important to you. The Moran agencies are here to protect your future. We are here to build a water protection around you and your family.
From your auto and life and retirement, the Moran Insurance Agency has you back. To protect your family from mayhem, please visit us at Moran Insurance Agencies.
Or give us a call at 203-864-6232.
All right, guys. All right, all right, all right. Shit is like... All right, guys. Here we come back to Super Elite Entertainment. Again, I'm your host, Jason Rodriguez, broadcasting from the city of Bridgeport, Connecticut. So, I don't know how this is going to play out. I don't know what Lola has in her mind. But listen, I want to throw the consent out there right now. Because I know that there are some kids who watch the show every single week. And especially, you know, oh my God, I can't remember his name right now. I apologize. Gio, put his name in the timeline, my little young brother. Pero, yeah, we're here in the studio broadcasting from the Super Elite Entertainment Show. And I just got to let you guys know that... it might get a little twisted. It might get a little crazy. Lola is very feisty with her words. She likes to, you know, to get crazy with certain things that she say periodically. Baco as well. Baco, you guys, listen, Baco is just wide open right now. I don't know if you are aware of the you know, the backdrop or the backstory leading up to right now. But if you're thinking that Baco and Lola are going to meet tonight, they're not going to meet. What's going to happen is Lola's going to join me on the show momentarily. I'm going to give her an opportunity to speak. She's going to express herself in regards to everything that has been taking place between her and Baco. And, you know, if you guys don't know, Baco arrived here about a month ago from Arizona. The plan was that he was supposed to move from Arizona here to Bridgeport, Connecticut to be with Lola, all right? With Lola Rodriguez. Lola is... she's a diva. She's the queen of this studio. And she's also my co-host alongside Giovanni Alvarez. So, you know, the concern is that Lola went far and beyond the extra mile to help Baco get established. She helped him to get here. She's going to talk more about that. And, you know, unfortunately, Baco did, he did the shebanga. I want to find the right proper. He played her. He played her like a toy, like a fiddle. He played her like a fool. I mean, he got here and he went MIA. Nobody has been able to see Paco. Even myself, I haven't even seen Paco yet. I know that my buddy Z seeing him. I know Giovanni Alvarez has been seeing him. Gio called him at Spark City Smoke and Vape Shop a couple of times. Matter of fact, just the other day, without me knowing, because I keep my our work truck for the studio. That truck is kept here at the studio. So it looks like Baco came here and stole my truck. He returned it. He returned it after he found out that the cops were looking for him. But Baco returned the truck, but he stole the truck and he was moving around the city of Bridgeport in my truck. No permission. He don't even have license. But he stole my truck. He was caught by Gio. Gio confronted him. And Baco basically just, you know, told him to kick rocks. But what I was trying to say was, I want to put the consent out there. Any kids that are watching tonight, I don't recommend for them to watch because Lola's going to get a little bit raw. She's going to get a little bit crazy. Baco went all out. When Baco's first episode drops momentarily, that's going to be like maybe PG-18, PG-21. But yeah, I encourage that there'll be no kids watching tonight. Let's see here. Gio, what's the name of my little young brother? What's his name, Gio? Put his name on the timeline. Come on. Baco's MIA. He's been MIA for 30 days. Yes, he has been MIA for 30 days. But again, we're going to get started momentarily with Lola. She's going to come on here. She's going to, you know, she's just going to express herself. She's going to say what she has to say. And we're going to go from there, guys. All right. So this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to take a quick break. I'm going to show you this video of the city of Bridgeport, which is an amazing city that we live in right here. And when we come back, Lola will be joining me. And then we're going to jump into that episode with Paco. All right, guys? So don't go anywhere. We'll be right back momentarily. All right, you guys. Yep, you already know who it is. It's me, Lola. And I am broadcasting from the Super Elite Entertainment Studio right here in the city of Bridgeport, Connecticut. Hey, guys, how you doing? As you already know, I am Lola. I'm the most sexiest, the most amazing. Hey, listen, guys. Look at my hair. Woo, sexy, right? Look at my hair. Yep, check it out. Look at my eyes. They're so blue. Oh, my God. Hey, but anyhow, I'm excited to be here. Gio, that's why you're not here tonight, Gio, because I'm here, and I'm the real co-host of this show. But anyhow, guys, you guys know I've been going through a lot lately. I've been suffering, dealing with a whole lot of, whoa, Lola, hold on, slow down. Don't you even dare say a bad word on the air. All right, I'm not trying to pay any fines. Slow your roll. Don't go crazy with your choice of words. Relax. I'm providing you an opportunity to express yourself tonight. Greet the people. Say what you have to say. Get off your chest what you have to say. I mean, there's a great possibility that Paco's watching. So make sure that you pick your words wisely, especially if you're trying to fix your relationship with Paco. I guarantee you he's watching right now somewhere out here in the city of Bridgeport. So be careful with your words. Okay, Jason, I understand what you're trying to say. So guys, how you doing? My name is Lola, and I'm the most sexiest, the most attractive, the most of everything here in the city of Bridgeport. You know what, guys? Lately, I've been having so many guys chasing after me. So many men, so many young men. They're all after me. And it's unfortunate because, you know, I thought that me and Paco was supposed to be in a relationship. Now, anyhow, that's what I wanted to come out here and talk about. I've been going through a lot, guys. I've been going through a lot. I was fooled by Paco. Paco played me like a fiddle. This is what happened. Let me be honest, very, very transparent and honest with you guys. Paco, when I first met Paco, and I'm going to be honest, I'm going to be so open with what I have to say. I met Paco while he was incarcerated in Arizona. Paco was in jail. We became pen pals. We started writing each other. And yeah, I know I'm stupid, girls. I know I'm stupid because the first thing I did was I started sending him money. I sent him a money order for $5. Then, you know, from $5, it went to $10. Then from $10, it went to $20. And then from $20, the money orders just kept increasing all the way up to the point that I sent him $500 so that he can buy a TV so that he can entertain himself while he's in jail. I know I'm stupid for doing that, girls. I know. I admit right now, I allowed myself to be blinded by Paco. And it was so blinding that, you know what, I wasn't really aware of what I was doing. I gave in. He asked me for money. He asked me for, you know, all these different types of things. Then, when Paco got to the halfway house, yes, he got to a halfway house. I'm being really open with you guys. Paco was incarcerated. He got to the halfway house. When he got to the halfway house, I sent him a whole bunch of more money. I sent them all kind of, you know, pants and shirts and underwears and sneakers and brand new Uptowns and Nikes and stuff like that. And I know I'm stupid. I know I'm an idiot for what I've done. But things got worse. You know, I went from, you know, taking care of him and making sure that he was established there at the halfway house that it got to the point, guys, that, well, this is what happened. He asked me for a cell phone while he was in a halfway house. And, you know, me as an idiot, I went down to Sprint. Got him a cell phone, and I mailed it to him. And the 6 months that he was in a halfway house, that's how we communicated. That's how we spent our time, FaceTiming each other, sending each other text messages and pictures. Now, I'm not going to admit, I never sent them any naked picture. That's not me. I'm a diva. Hashtag divas. Divas don't do stuff like that, okay? Divas don't do stuff like that. But I did some foolish things. I sent them a phone, okay? I sent Paco a phone. We started communicating while he was in a halfway house. And then, as he was getting close to his discharge date, Paco started telling me, I have nowhere to go, Lola. I have nowhere to go. Can you please send me some money so that I can buy a ticket so I can get down there to Connecticut so I can be with you? Paco knows I have a nice house. You know, I'm a diva. I mean, come on. Look at me. I'm a diva. I got it all going on, okay? There's no denying the fact that I'm sexy. There's no denying the fact that I have a lot of money in the bank. There's no denying the fact that, you know what? I'm just the it. Theit.com. Bomb.com. Yeah, that's me. But at the same time, I became a fool. I sent Paco airline tickets. I sent Paco a ticket to get on the train. Once Paco got here to Bridgeport, Connecticut, I was waiting for him at the train. I was there waiting for him. And his train was supposed to arrive at 10 p.m. at night. Downtown Bridgeport. I'm sitting there waiting for Paco to get off the train. And guess what, guys? He got off the train, but then he disappeared. 1 month, yesterday, 30 days, Paco has been missing in action. Nobody can find Paco. He blinded me. He played me like a fool. And now I'm hearing that he's out there moving around the city, talking about he's trying to relocate. And, you know, it's unfortunate because Paco is up to no good. Paco is drinking. Paco is smoking. God knows what he's smoking. And then now we know with this whole new law that was passed, now you can have weed. Now you can have weed, marijuana, pasto. Now you can smoke all the weed you want up to an ounce and a half in your possession. You can even have plants in your house. You can grow your own weed. And I guarantee you that Paco is doing that right now. That's probably what he's smoking. That's why he's missing in action and his life is all messed up. Paco, I know you're watching. I know you're watching. And I would not even dare to sit here and to beg you to come back to me. Even though I really want you to come, Paco. Even though I want you back. You hurt me. You played me. But I still want you back, Paco. I don't want you back and I do want you back. This is a tough situation, guys. And I don't know how to go about it. You know, Jason, what do you recommend? Well, Lola, I'm going to be honest with you. First of all, I mean, I think it was really foolish of you to send Paco money, all right? I mean, I understand he was incarcerated. I understand he was in a halfway house. Stuff happens. Things go down in individuals' lives where sometimes they're, you know, they put themselves in situations that are unfortunate. So Paco was incarcerated. He successfully was discharged. He went to the halfway house. He discharged. Paco, you know, I mean, listen, it's unfortunate, but I could have seen it from the start. The moment that he started asking you for money, I would have ran, all right? Because in jail, these guys are allowed to have jobs. In jail, these guys are allowed to go to school. They're allowed to pursue their education. They're allowed to get college credits. And they get paid for going to school. They get paid for the jobs that they do inside the correctional facilities. So it's unfortunate that you allowed yourself to be played by this dude. I mean, honestly, based on what I've been seeing lately, and I'm around you all the time, just the other day, you were in bed crying. 1 minute, you want Paco. The next minute, you don't. 1 minute, you're trying to kick it to some dude. The next minute, you're crying about Paco. I just seen you talking to this dude named Angelo, who owns Nexus Auto Glass. You approached this guy. I seen the video. It was caught on video, Lola. You approached this guy, and you started kicking it to him, which is crazy. You started kicking it to him, and you know what? He started kicking it back to you, to be honest with you. And you were loving it. You were loving it. And that's the thing that I'm confused about with you, Lola, is either you want Paco or you don't. 1 minute you want him, 1 minute you don't. I mean, what's the deal? Do you want him or you don't want him? What's the deal? Jason, I really do want Paco. And I'm going to be honest with you. With all the pain that he created and caused in my life and in my heart, I shed a lot of tears. You witnessed it. You seeing it. That's the reason why you took me to Mystic just the other week, this past weekend. You took me to Mystic so that I can spend some time out in solitude, so I can get out there and smell the air. And you know, I appreciate the fact that you took me out there. But I mean, it's unfortunately. Yeah. And Gio, yeah, I do hate you, Gio. I do hate you, and I hate Paco as well. And I know that you got some information. I know that you know the 411 on Paco. I know that you and Z know where Paco is, because I heard that you guys been hanging out with him. So, yes, Gio, I hate you. Yes, I hate you, okay? I hate you for stealing my job. I hate you for knowing what's going on with Paco and not bringing him to me. But, Jason, to answer your question, I am suffering. I gave Paco all my money. I depleted my bank account. I have no money. I don't even have money in my account to go to the corner store to buy a pack of bubblegum or a pack of non-laters. That's how bad my situation is. I've been going to the Prospect House. And yeah, you know, I come on social media and I always say, hashtag diva, but I'm suffering. I have no money. Whatever I eat is because you give me to eat, Jason. And when I have nothing to eat, I go down to the Prospect House and I get into the line for the soup kitchen and I sit there with all the homeless people and I eat. I swallow my pride. And this is a direct result of what Paco has done to me. Paco played me. He has taken everything that I am. He has taken my heart. He has crushed me. But hey, listen, I believe in resilience. I believe in bouncing back. I know it's going to happen, Jason. I know it's going to happen. But you know what? It's going to happen. Lola, listen, I agree with you. It's going to happen in a matter of time, but it's all about you getting past this debacle. He's no good for you. I'm telling you right now, as a friend, as your boss, as your co-host, I'm telling you that Paco is no good for you. And I'm going to show you why he's no good for you. Because there was, you know what? Paco was down at Spark City Smoke and Vape Shop. And he don't know, but the cameras were running the whole time. You're going to see a whole different side of Paco that you don't know about, Lola. He likes to smoke. He likes to drink. He likes to hang out. He likes to party. He's been hanging out at all the clubs out here in Bridgeport, where there's Evolution. And there's nothing wrong with going to clubs. But if you came here to Bridgeport to meet your, you know, the love of your life, he said that you were the love of his life, right? That's what he said. I mean, if Paco came here to meet the love of his life, he shouldn't be been, you know, immediately hanging out in Evolution and Sasong and Mambo and all these other clubs. And there's nothing wrong with that, because I go to those places and I enjoy myself when I go there. But Paco, right off the rip, getting off the plane, off the train, ran into the club, ran into Spark City, grabbed himself something to smoke, hanging out in the blocks. He's been moving. I heard he's been hanging out in front of Coquito, right there in front of East Main, right in front of Coquito on East Main Street. And let me tell you who told me that information. A good friend of mine, who I call Uncle Ronald. Ronald called me and he said, "Hey, yo, Jay, you've been looking for this Dupaco, right?" And I'm like, yeah. You know, Lola, man, she's going through it, man. She did everything for this dude to get here, and he's been MIA. Well, you know what? Ronald told me, dude is right here right now, drinking a 40-ounce of Heineken and smoking a blunt. I could not believe it. I was like, are you serious? And right before, you know, Ronald was able to get some video or a picture of what he was doing, it's unfortunate, Lola, that he, you know, I mean, it's just an unfortunate situation because, you know, Ronald wasn't able to get the footage that I needed so I can show you what kind of person Paco really is, Lola. But you're going to see tonight, because right now we're going to drop this video. It's almost 20 minutes long, but you're going to see for yourself what Paco is all about. So I want you to understand, Lola, that the guy you've been crying about and begging to come and see you and begging to come back to you and the dude that you gave all your money to, he had a lot of things to say, and he don't even know that he was recorded on camera. So check it out, all right? I guarantee you, you're going to be disappointed. Are you ready to watch this, Lola? Yes or no? Jason, I am ready to watch this video. And I tell you right now, if this guy disrespects me, if he comes out of his mouth sideways, I'm telling you right now, I swear to goodness, I swear on everything, Jason, I am going to take your gun, and I am going to get raw. Lola is going to get raw, 007 raw, all right? I am going to go and look for this guy, and I'm going to find him. Even if I got to take an Uber, even if I got to steal your car again, Jason, I'm going to steal your car, I'm going to steal your guns, and I'm going to go raw on this guy. I'm sorry, because Jason, this is just so hard. Lola, you need to relax. You need to relax, Lola. I mean, please, you're not stealing nobody's car. You're not taking any of my weapons. You're not going to look for Paco. All you got to do is cut him off. Cut them off like a habit. Let him go. He's no good for you. I've been telling you this since day one, but you don't listen. And this is a direct consequence of what it is that you blocked your ear from listening to. I've been telling you this for a long time, right? But you don't want to listen. You don't care. Jason, okay. Okay, Jason, listen. Let's watch the video. And just I just pray that it's not as bad as you're making it sound. I mean, I still love Paco. I'm crying for him right now. And I just hope that wherever you are, Paco, if you're watching, I'll take you back. I'll take you back, Paco. I don't care. Everything that happened, I'll let it go. I'll let it go. And I'll take you back, Paco. You know I love you. I know I never seen you. That's the worst part. I never seen you. But I know that you're watching right now. And Gio, you're an idiot. Don't you ever call Paco a sucio. The only sucio out there is you for stealing my job here in the studio. So don't ever, ever disrespect my man Paco and call him sucio again. Okay, Gio? Oh my God, Lola. Relax, girl. Breathe. Like literally, legit, you need to breathe. Calm down. Because you're about to make me cut the show short. I'm about to get up and leave if you don't relax. All right? I'm going to drop the video. Are you ready? Jason, I am ready. Let's watch this video. Right now, play it. And I just hope for the best. Paco, please come back to me. Please, Paco, come back to me. Please, please come back to me. All right, guys. So listen, I'm going to drop this video right now. And this video is all about Lola. And, well, it's not really about Lola. It's all about Paco. Paco was out there, I heard, in Spark City Smoke and Vape Shop, located right here in the city of Bridgeport. Lola, just take it easy. Just relax. I'm going to hold your hand. I promise you, I'm going to hold your hand. Okay, listen. Come here. I'm going to hold your hand, all right? I'm going to hold your hand while we watch the video. Don't worry. I got your hand right here. And, guys, we're going to drop this video in. I hope that, you know, you enjoy it. Have some good laughs, and we're going to come right back momentarily. Me and Lola is right here in the studio live with you, and we're going to watch this video. So enjoy. Don't go anywhere. No se muevan. And this is the type of guy that Paco is all about. I've been telling Lola since day one that Paco's no good. I've been telling her since day one not to hook up with this dude. But she don't like to listen. This is a direct consequence to her hardening her heart and not paying any attention to the advice that I was giving her. Why would you come to me, Lola, and ask me for advice and then not listen? This is just ridiculous. But this is your man. This is the footage that was caught, okay? There at Spark City Smoke and Vape Shop. Matter of fact, this is the worst part. He rolled up in there using my name, talking about I sent them there so that he can get a smoke. You a damn liar, Paco. And I swear to goodness, you treating Lola so bad right now that if I was to catch you, I'm going to put a whooping on that ass. I'm going to be honest with you, man, but you a disrespectful dude coming at Lola the way you did, treating her so disrespectfully. If I catch you moving around here in the city like you've been talking about relocating, trying to find your place, I'm going to relocate you, and you're going to find your place somewhere, all right? I'm going to make sure that you get arrested and get prosecuted and sent back to jail where you belong for doing what you done to Lola. But anyhow, guys, here we go. I'm going to drop this video. Paco, doing whatever the hell he does, talking about he moving around and relocating. Enjoy. I'll be right back momentarily after this video, guys. No se muevan.
Hey, what's up, Z?
What's up, Paco? What you doing here?
Oh, I'm just here to smoke a cigar, brother. You know, I've been stressing and going through a lot.
I hear that. I've been seeing you stressed out.
Yeah, it's been a tough 2 weeks.
Yeah.
But I wanted to just smoke a cigar and relax. I was recommended to stop by here. You know Jason from Super Elite Entertainment?
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah, he told me if I stopped by here and mentioned his name, that you would give me a discount and allow me to smoke a cigar in the back lounge.
That's very hard, you know. What I heard about something else.
What you heard?
You're not being seeing Lola.
Hey, listen. First of all, don't question me about Lola and what's going on with my relationship. I'm here as a professional customer, and all I want to do is smoke me a cigar. Is that okay?
No, it's not. You gotta meet Lola very soon. She's been looking for you.
She be alright. She be alright. Hey, so, listen.
I'll let you smoke cigar this time since Jason sent you, but next time you gotta come with Lola.
Hey, listen, man.
Both your cigars are gonna be on the house if you both come.
Oh, I appreciate that. I appreciate that. So, what you're telling me, Z, is that if I come next time with Lola, my boo, my girl, my honey, you know what's good. She know who her man is. You're gonna give me a cigar and Lola?
Yep.
I appreciate that.
Don't bring Gio with you, because that's gonna create more problems.
Hey, listen, man, let me tell you something. You know that dude, Gio? You know that dude?
Yep.
Yeah, because my girl seems to have a big problem with this dude, man. So, yo, I mean, honestly, I'm getting to the point where I'm gonna have to hunt this dude down and put some hurt on this dude.
If you're with Lola, that wouldn't happen. You've been missing an action.
Hey, let me cut you off right there. Let me cut you off right there. Because you keep constantly questioning my relationship with Lola. My man, listen, stick to your business. Mind your own business. And don't worry about what I have going on in my life with my girl. My relationship is my life. Okay, bro?
Nope, because she's been bothering Gio. She's bothering me, too. Because you're missing an action.
Hey, all right, well, listen, man. Listen, for right now, I'm stressing. I'm going through a lot. All I want is a cigar.
All right, let's go get a cigar for you.
Oh, okay. You're gonna escort me to the humidifier?
I'll show you where the humidifier
is. Oh, okay. I appreciate that. I appreciate that. This place is pretty lit, man.
Yep.
He got everything in this place.
What kind of cigar you like?
All right. So, Z, listen, man. Listen. I'm not a smoker, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Even though people have been talking about I've been missing in action and out there doing my thing and getting drunk and smoking, and I'm not really a smoker.
I want to
smoke something that's tasty.
That's
gonna spark up my tongue and my lips.
All right. I'll show you something.
Okay, show me what you got, brother. Appreciate you.
Never smoke this cigar because this is what Jason smokes.
Hey, wait, Jason smokes those Camachos?
Yep.
Okay.
Never smoked that.
Okay.
But I got some good cigars, brand new cigars out here.
Oh, let me walk around here and check for myself.
Let me
check for myself. Let's see. Oh, AZ, you know what? I like these right here.
All right.
Nesticos? Yep. I like those.
All right.
Yeah.
Let's take one. I'm gonna cut it up for you.
Uh-huh.
Go to the back.
All right.
I'll be right there when I see you.
Oh, okay. I appreciate that. So you're gonna cut the cigar for me?
Yep, absolutely.
All right. Yeah, guys, listen, man, if you're out in the area...
Since this is the first time, I'll show you where the lounge is.
Oh, okay, thank you. Hey, guys, listen, man, if you're ever in the area, stop by here. This place is lit. It's called Spark City Smoking Vape. This guy, Z, I mean, he's sort of getting in my business, but at the same time, he seems like a good guy. But 815 Lafayette Boulevard, Bridgeport, Connecticut, Spark City Smoking Vape Shop, amazing place. I'm about to get lit.
If you want to relax a little bit more, right there.
Oh, what we got right here?
More relaxing stuff on that side.
Oh, is that a hookah pipe?
Yep.
Oh, man, you know what? AZ, listen, man. Listen, first of all, can you just do me a favor and not mention to Lola that I'm here?
Okay.
All right. And with that said, you got any CBD? I want to get nice, nice.
Nice, nice?
Yeah, nice, nice.
When you come with Lola?
Hey, listen,
you're
man.
You're going to make up with Lola. Both of you come. And we're going to make a nice evening out of it.
Hey, okay. I appreciate that. Let me just get that cigar to my mouth right now.
Let's go. Have a seat, and I'll be right back with the cigar.
Okay, so this is the lounge, huh?
This is the lounge.
Hey, Z, let me get a light.
You want a light?
Yeah, let me get a light, brother.
All right. Here you go, Paco.
Oh.
Light it up. Nice and slow.
Yeah, thank you, Z.
Yeah. Don't be like Jason.
Hey, it's just what I need, man, to calm my brain down a little bit. You know what I mean?
There we go.
Yeah, thank you, man.
All right, let's smoke it.
Yeah, see, this cigar's pretty good, man. What's the flavor of this cigar?
Natural hand-rolled cigar.
Natural hand-rolled cigar?
Yes.
You rolled it?
You're gonna enjoy it. I wish I did.
Yeah, no doubt I'm enjoying this.
Today,
yeah.
But it's a very good cigar. It's Placentia.
Listen, man, you don't know how much this means to me, brother. Straight up. Now. Yeah, you know, this is the problem, Z. I've been stressing like hell, man.
Mm-hmm.
You know, this girl, you know my girl Lola, right?
Yeah, what's going on with you guys? You've been missing in action. You've been hanging out with Jason only. I mean, why do you want to see Lola?
Well, listen, you know, I've been here 2 weeks, and I'm just contemplating. I don't know what to do about her, brother. I'm thinking about cutting her off, man, because I heard some rumors. I heard some things that she had going something on with that dude, Gio. I don't know how true it is, man.
It's not really that true. It's not. Everything is not true. Don't believe everything you see. Go sit down with Lola. Have a talk with her. If you got a problem with Gio, we'll take care of him.
Okay,
me and Jason, we're gonna take care of him.
Okay. I respect that. So when you say take care of him, you mean that gun that you're wearing on your hip? You gonna take care of him that way?
Maybe not that way. But we're gonna take care of him. We're gonna take him to Seaside and take care of him.
Okay.
Yeah.
I don't know what to do with myself, man. I've just been going through a lot. I'm homeless right now. Can't find a job, Z. I was wondering if you could give me a job here at Spark City.
All right. How about it? We make a deal. You and Lola make up, get Gio out of the picture. I'll see what I can do for you.
I appreciate that, man. Hey, you got a drink? I'm feeling like I want to turn up. You got anything to drink?
Absolutely. What do you want to drink?
I mean, I'll take some Bacardi, some Hennessy, whatever you got to drink, man. I want to turn up.
I got the best drink for you.
You got what?
I got the best of the best drink.
What's that?
I got the Johnny Arca Blue Label for you.
Woo-wee! Yeah, let's drink some. Give me a shot,
bro. Gonna have a party out here.
Yeah, give me a shot. Hey, listen. Real quick before you go. Any girls around here?
No.
What?
No, you gotta make up with Lola first. Don't be thinking about other stuff. We just talked about this. Don't be going back to somebody else again. You know, Gio has been trying to do this for a long time. He's trying to take Lola out. So go back to Lola, make up with her. We'll see about other stuff later.
Hey, listen, man. I need something new in my life. You know, I'm Paco. I don't know if you're familiar with who I am, but I'm just a man.
In the two weeks you've been here, I've been gotten very familiar with you.
I've been seeing you. Watch your mouth. Uh-huh. You ain't got to get slick with your mouth now.
You want a drink? You better to listen to me.
Let me get that drink and we'll go from there. Yep. Serve me a drink, brother.
All right, let's have a drink. We got our drinks right here. For you, since it's a special occasion, first time here, got you Johnny Walker Blue Label New York Edition.
Johnny Walker Blue Label New York Edition?
Yep.
Hey, man, that sounds very expensive, brother.
For you, not a problem.
Thank you, brother, man. This is the first time in Connecticut that somebody in Bridgeport really looks out for me with something nice. Thank you for the charity, brother. Thank you,
You're
brother.
Most welcome. Let's have a drink.
All right, crack that baby open, because I'm ready to turn up. We're going to take a ride, and we're going to go and we're going to find a couple of chicky chicks.
All right.
Chicky chicks.
We'll do that. We'll go to Seaside after this.
Hey, Seaside
going to take
Park.
A ride to the Seaside.
Hey, I love that part, brother.
All right, let's have a drink.
Oh, man, this is awesome.
Let's have a drink, Paco.
Z. Wow. That really hit the pocket, brother. Now I'm feeling good. Now I'm feeling alive.
Yeah.
Now I'm ready to take on the world.
Lola's been riding around. I heard she's been looking for you, so.
If
she sees you, we're going to have a problem.
Yeah, listen, man.
Not only you. Me, Jason... Gio, we all gonna get into the problem.
Hey, I'm a grown-ass man. I don't care what about anything that Lola got to say. And I'm living my life. I've been here two and a half weeks, homeless, hungry. AZ, can I be honest with you and open about something?
Go ahead.
I'm living in my car, brother.
See, that's what I've been trying to say to you since you walked in.
It's rough.
Up with Lola. She has a nice home. She got a car. She got everything.
Brother, how are you going to say she has a nice home if she's living in the closet?
That's what she tells you.
Uh-huh.
Once you get home, she's going to stay in the bedroom. She's alone. That's why she's in the closet.
Okay. All right. Well, listen, man. That drink is hitting the pocket right now. I feel it working. I feel it working its way down into my belly.
I'm feeling it, too. It's feeling great.
This cigar got me a little tipsy, too. Is there alcohol in this cigar?
No, but you can dip the cigar in the alcohol.
Ah!
You can do that.
I love it.
Just
hey,
like
so...
Dip the end?
Uh-huh.
Perfect.
Hey! That's a new trick I just learned.
Yeah.
Hey, I appreciate that, Z. So listen, man. I'm about to get out of here.
All right.
I got a couple of things that I got to go and do. You know, I've been moving around the city trying to make some power moves and trying to reestablish myself out here and relocate and get my life right. So I'm trying to get my situation right so I can you know, hook up with Lola and get a nice home and bring her, you know, to live with me, man. So
yeah, you gotta start doing that. Start trying. You've been here for a long time. You gotta meet up.
Yeah. That's gonna happen eventually. But I got a few little things I gotta slap up real quick. You know what I mean? But mm-hmm. But for right now, thank you so much for the cigar. Thank you for the hospitality. Thank you for the drink. Thank you for everything, brother. You're a stand up citizen, man.
Thank you. Hey, listen, we're gonna have a party pretty soon. Jira is gonna be there.
Uh huh.
Jason is gonna be there.
Uh huh.
Some other people are gonna be there.
Okay.
So is Lola.
Whoa.
How about we meet? We all meet that day. Have a drink together.
You mean?
Gonna have dinner together. Get things right.
You mean? Where is this gonna take place at?
Bridgeport, right here in Bridgeport.
Right here at the lounge.
Yep.
Hey. Okay.
Right here in the lounge. You know, we're gonna go around Bridgeport first. We're gonna meet up in the lounge later.
Okay. Hey, how about? Hey. Listen.
Yeah.
I seen on Instagram yesterday you were riding a scooter yesterday, huh?
Yeah.
Hey. Hey, you think I can get a ride on one of those?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Let's go to Seaside. We're gonna ride the scooter.
Hey.
So, I got the best one in the city. Hey. Better than Jason's.
Hey, listen, man. First of all, Jason's a stand-up guy. He's been taking care of my girl Lola for a long time. When she was homeless and dropped off at the Goodwill, he rescued her.
Let me cut you off right there. He got tired of taking off care of Lola. That's why Gio came in the picture.
what are you talking about, brother?
He got tired of Lola.
Who got tired of Lola?
Jason got tired of Lola. That's why he brought Gio in the picture to help him out.
He didn't tell me nothing about. He didn't tell me that.
See?
Okay.
Yeah. Ask him.
Okay, so there's a little twist to the whole story now. Okay. Mm-hmm. All right, because the whole time, he's been telling me how he's been feeding her, clothing her, housing her, you know, doing all these things for her. But so basically, he's been lying to me?
No, it's half a lie, half truth. The first part, he took care of her for a while.
Okay.
But he got tired of her. You were not showing up. You were nowhere to be found.
Well, listen.
And Jason was like, you know what? I had enough. You know, I got many other things to do. So he sends it off with Gio. And that's how the thing with Gio started.
Let me ask you a question before I get out of here, brother. Let me ask you a real good question, man. Do you think Lola is sleeping with Jason and Gio? You think she got something going on with one of them two?
I think they didn't go that far yet. I think she's still waiting for you. That's why she's in the closet. If she was with either one of them... She wouldn't be in the closet. She'd be in the bedroom.
She's still in the closet. Whoa, brother. Those words are strong. Strong words.
You gotta hear strong words for you.
Strong words you just used against me, brother.
Yeah.
I don't wanna whoops at you. I don't wanna whoops at you. Don't make me whoops at you with this hand, brother.
You gotta hear the hard truth. This is the hard truth.
Don't disrespect me, Z.
You gotta go get her back soon. Otherwise, you're gonna lose her forever.
Let me ask you something, man. You act like you Dr. Phil. You act like you know all the answers.
Like
you know everything that's going on in somebody's life. Let's talk about you and your life, fool. Let's talk about you, Z.
Let's talk about me.
I mean, what's good, brother?
Everything is good.
No, ain't nothing good.
Everything is good. See, you walked in. I was in my lounge smoking a cigar, having a drink.
Okay, Dr. Phil.
Alive,
okay, know? Dr. Phil. Okay. All right. Well, listen, I'm going to get out of here. Thank all you right. for the cigar and the drink.
You're most welcome. It was nice having you know, a drink you're, with you're, you. I hope next time. I have a drink with you and Lola and Jason and Gio.
Okay, well, listen, man. God bless you. God bless you. Take care. And, hey, you guys, again, if you're watching, come out here. Spark City Smoking Vape, located at 815 Lafayette Boulevard in Bridgeport, Connecticut. This place is awesome. Great cigars, great vapes, great hookah, great everything here. Hey, if you like to smoke vape, you like coconut? I love coconut. They got plenty of coconut pina colada. They got coffee flavors. Whatever it is you need, whatever it is you're looking for, this dude Z, he got everything. All right? And with that said, God bless. Take care, guys. Woo! Bye-bye. Thank you.
Welcome to ACES Bail Bonds.
Do you need information regarding bail bonds and the bail bond process? Contact us at ACES Bail Bonds, where we are happy to give you a free bail consultation. You are in capable hands with our reputable agency. For fast, reliable bail bond service, get out of jail fast with ACES Bail Bonds. You can save time and money by calling ahead. We'll have the forms ready for you, with everything handled privately, discreetly, and confidentially at our office. For fast, reliable bail bond service, call ACES Bail Bonds now.
Welcome to Ramirez Restaurant.
Right, you guys, welcome back to Live with Jason Rodriguez. Listen, guys, I had to put some music on to build up the momentum, the mood inside here, because unfortunately, I kept telling Lola what's good. She got mad. She left running out the studio, crying. She started throwing stuff all over the place, blaming me for what's going on between her and Paco. I'm like, yo, what is you talking about? I got a TV screen over here. The screen right now was laying on the ground, on the floor. She threw two chairs over. The microphone, she threw that up against the wall. I can see a little piece over there on the ground. I mean, Lola, she lost it, unfortunately. And it's a direct result of her, you know, not listening. She should have listened to the things that I've been telling her. I gotta take a sip of water, man, because she got me stressing. But I hope you guys enjoyed that video. I want to give a big shout out to Spark City Smoke and Vape Shop for allowing us to film that video there. Big shout out to the owner, Z, my good friend. Big shout out to Giovanni Alvarez, my co-host, who was the man behind the camera. You know, he caught all those good angles, and you know, Gio knows his craft, and big shout out to Gio. I hope you guys enjoyed that video, man. If you see Paco somewhere moving around the city of Bridgeport, if you see him again somewhere in my truck, call 911, call me, direct message me, hit me up as soon as you can, and I'll respond accordingly. All right, if I can't get there, I got some little cousins that'll get there for me. They'll take care of, you know, my little small troubles for me. So, all right, guys, let me check the timeline and see how everybody's doing. I've been around. Okay, so SK General. Okay, he's talking to somebody out there. She needs to go find Julio and stop crying. Damn it, laugh my ass off. It's 2021. He's at Pleasant Moments. You know what? I have to agree with you, Christina. He might be at Pleasant Moments. Natalia is saying so funny. And listen, Natalia, it's not a funny situation. I mean, what Lola's going through is serious. It's serious business, man. And she's suffering. She just left running, you know, outside the studio. I got cameras facing outside. And I can see her right now walking up and down the sidewalk right there on Fearful Avenue in front of the Murphy's Law in the Bijou Theater. She's just moving around and walking up and down. I can see her right now just... Oh, my God. I know she didn't just... You know what? Lola's going to get arrested. She's going to get arrested. She just punched the window of a car. I can't believe this. Listen, guys, I got to get out of here. I got to get myself outside to help Lola. She's about to get herself in a serious situation. So, again, thank you guys so much for tuning in tonight. I'm the host of this show. My name is Jason Rodriguez. I have Paco joining me. I had Lola joining me. I had Z from Spark City Smoke and Vape joining me tonight. And, you know, I think it went well. Well, maybe not too well, because Lola's out there having a meltdown, a breakdown, crying over some dude that can't do nothing for her. Pero, I'm about to get out of here, guys. Thank you so much for tuning in tonight. I'll be back next week, next Tuesday night at 8 p.m. broadcasting live from the Super Elite Entertainment Studio with my co-host Giovanni Alvarez. We're going to be here. Gio will be right here side by side with me. We're going to have a good time. We're going to chop it up. And we got to catch up. We got to catch up because it's been a couple of weeks. And I still didn't forget about our competition, Gio, with you and me facing each other right there at the bowling alley. I've been working out, man. I've been getting my arms ready. I'm ready to grab that bowling ball and spank you with it. But anyhow, guys, thank you so much for tuning in. I hope you had a lot of laughs the same way I did. I was cracking up here while I was watching all that footage with Paco. And I had a good time, guys. Thank you so much for the love and the support. Thank you for tuning in. And again, we'll be back here next Tuesday night at 8 p.m. God bless. Good night. I got to get outside and help Lola before Bridgeport PD arrives. I'll see you guys next week. Lo fuimos. Here we go. We're going to leave with a nice song. Lo fuimos. Take care, guys.